Hello everyone, in this module I will talk about quantum mechanics of atomic structure. In the last part I have talked about basics of atom and atomic structure. Here I will discuss the fundamental part of the quantum mechanics in order to understand atomic structure. So no adequate discussion of electronic structure is possible without reference to the quantum mechanics. So first I will talk about some important success of classical quantum theory. Now classical quantum theory deals with the electron as a particle. In the older quantum mechanics, electron is considered to be a particle, and thereby they calculate all the equation and explain the quantum mechanics of atomic structure. So first, what is electromagnetic radiation? Now electromagnetic radiation consists of waves waves in the electromagnetic field propagating through space carrying the electromagnetic radiant energy. So you can see that this light is a electromagnetic radiation. It composed of electrical field and magnetic field. So in this picture you can see that this is the electromagnetic radiation, and it has two component, two vector part. One, that white shaded area is shown as shown below, is the magnetic component of the light, and perpendicular to it there is another component, that is electrical part of the radiation, the wave. So electromagnetic radiation consists of two component. One is the electrical part and magnetic part. The subatomic particle like electron, photon, they both have particle nature and wave property. So in this video lecture I will talk about this particle nature of this subatomic particle electron, and in the next part I will talk about the wave properties. From there new quantum mechanics comes into picture. So in order to understand different electromagnetic radiation, we have to know that different parameter which describes the this electromagnetic radiation. First is the frequency, which is written by this symbol nu, and the unit of this frequency is hertz, that is nothing but second inverse, and the wavelength, which is written as by the symbol lambda, and the unit is same as that of distance, like nanometer. So all the electromagnetic radiation that compose the spectrum, whole spectrum, follow the same fundamental formula, that is lambda, the wavelength, multiplication of this frequency of this radiation is equal to the velocity of the light. So this is the fundamental equation that all the electromagnetic radiation obeys. So therefore you can see that this wavelength lambda and this frequency, this frequency nu, they are inversely proportional to each other. As you can see by this formula, lambda, that is wavelength, is inversely proportional to the frequency of the light. So you can understand by looking at this visible spectrum of the electromagnetic radiation, and by increasing the wavelength from blue light 400 nanometer to this red light 700 nanometer, there is an increase in the wavelength, and subsequently in this order there is a decrease in the frequency. As you can see by this formula, when you increase the wavelength of the light, it will decrease the its frequency, which means that also decrease its energy. I will talk about it in the upcoming slide in detail also. Let us first try this example, and in order to understand this electromagnetic radiation part. So this is the red light, it has an associated wavelength 700 nanometer. As you can see, we have to calculate the frequency. Now how to do that? Now you know that basic fundamental formula, that is this wavelength lambda and this frequency is equal to velocity of the light. Now if you can just divided this c by this frequency is equal to c by lambda. If we put the value of c, which is nothing but 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second, and the lambda, it is given 700 nanometer. And if you convert this nanometer to meter, so it will come out to be 1 nanometer is equal to 10 to the power minus 9 meter. So if you just calculate this equation, you will find that the value comes out to be 4.2 into 10 to the power 14 second inverse, that is the unit of hertz, that is 4.2 into 10 to the power 14 hertz. So you can see that this frequency can be calculated easily by this fundamental formula. Now one point is that this wave nature of this light, the electromagnetic radiation, and it can be shown by this classical wave properties like this interference diffraction. These are the two fundamental properties by which one can prove that wave nature of the light, electromagnetic radiation. And I am taking this module in this chapter from this book. You can follow as a reference this Hauscroft book. Throughout my lecture I will follow this reference. So quantization of energy. Max Planck, a scientist, first postulated that energy was quantized and could be absorbed or emitted only in integral multiples of small units of energy, which is known as quanta. The energy of quanta is proportional to the frequency of the radiation, and the proportionality constant is a fundamental constant in science, which is known as Planck's constant, H, which is known as Planck's constant. So Planck's hypothesis first gave that an idea of that energy level quantization, and it helps to understand the further atomic structure. So as we have seen that equation E is equal to h nu, the equation gave by Planck, this is also a fundamental equation in science. This h is Planck's constant, and the value was given 6.62 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule into second. So by this equation you can understand the relation between energy and the frequency. Also you can modify this equation to further correlate the wavelength part also. The h nu you just divided by the c by lambda, it also give that equation of both the relation between this wavelength frequency with the energy. As you can understand by this equation, E energy of the radiation, electromagnetic radiation, is proportional to frequency, which is inversely proportional to wavelength of the light or radiation. So thereby we can understand that the light with larger wavelength, like red light, it has small frequency or small energy, or the light with lower wavelength like blue light, it has a higher energy, it has higher energy or higher frequency. So let us try this example, worked example. First you read the question carefully and then solve the question by yours and check the answer. So the question says that the so-called Lyman series of line in the emission spectrum of hydrogen atom correspond to transition from the various excited state to n is equal to 1 orbit, as I have already mentioned in the last slide. Now question is that calculate the wavelength that correspond to the lowest energy line in the Lyman series, and in what region this line comes. So you have to use this formula, Rydberg-Warth equation, 1 by lambda is equal to Rydberg constant multiply of this 1 by e non square minus 1 by e2 square. For the Lyman series, this value n1, it has to be 1 fixed. Now for the lowest energy transition, the n2 will be 2. Thereby you can put this n2 value, then 2 squared becomes 4. And if you calculate this 1 by lambda value by using this Rydberg constant Rh is equal to 1.097 into 10 to the power 7 meter inverse, you will get the value 1 by lambda. And 1 by lambda is nothing but wave number, nu bar. It is represented as nu bar, wave number, which is 1 by lambda, inversely proportional to wavelength. Therefore, lambda becomes this value centimeter inverse if you unit convert this meter to centimeter. And if you convert this meter to the nanometer range, you will find that this lambda comes out to be 122 nanometer. And if you just checkly do this electromagnetic spectrum, this list, you can see that this 122 nanometer falls in this ultraviolet region of this ultraviolet region. So it falls in UV region. And this line transition from n is equal to 2 to n2 is equal to n1 is equal to 1. This transition is called this alpha line of Lyman series. It gives the lowest energy transition. If the question suggests that the highest energy line in the Lyman series, then you have to take n2 is equal to infinity and n1, it has to fixed value 1. So you can understand that with the increase in the wavelength, with the increase in the principal quantum number from 2 to 3, 4 to infinity, the energy difference between this ground state becomes higher. Thereby, the higher energy line means from the higher energy state, the electron comes down to the ground excited state. Now comes the Bohr's theory of atomic spectrum of hydrogen. In the last video lecture, I have discussed the Bohr's atomic model and Bohr's contribution to the atomic structure. Here again, we can see that how Bohr's theory, Bohr postulate, help the scientists to interpret the emission spectrum of hydrogen atom. So in the 1913, Niels Bohr combined the elements of quantum theory and classical physics, and he postulated some theory regarding this hydrogen atom. Postulate 1 states that stationary states exist in which energy of the electron is constant. Such states are characterized by circular orbit about the nucleus in which angular momentum, that is mvr, which integral multiple of this h by 2 pi, where n is the principal quantum number and h by 2 pi is the constant, where m is the mass of the electron, v is the velocity of the electron moving around the nucleus in the orbit stationary state, and r is the radius of that particular orbit. So in the second postulate, he states that energy is absorbed or emitted only when an electron moves from one stationary state to the another stationary state. And this energy change delta E can be given by this equation E2 minus E1 is equal to h nu, where E2 is the excited state or higher energy level and E1 is the ground energy level. You can see by this picture diagram, so nucleus is positively charged and there is two orbit as shown over here. So electron when comes from this higher level to the lower level or promoted to this lower level to higher excited level, only then energy is emitted or absorbed. Now you can read the question carefully and try this example. So question says that the calculate delta E, that is the energy difference for an electron in hydrogen atom falling from n is equal to 2 state to 1, that is higher to lower energy. You can see from this figure, electron falls from this stationary state n is equal to 2 to this n is equal to 1 state. Thereby, when it jumps from this higher to lower level, it always emits a radiation. Now, you have to calculate this energy difference delta E. So, you can use the formula delta E is equal to final stage minus E is equal to initial is equal to C, that is a constant term, some constant term, multiplied by this 1 by n1 squared, that is 1, minus 1 by n2 squared, that is the 2. So when you calculate this equation, you will get the value minus 3 by 4 C. Here the significance of the sign is that negative sign indicates the its emission, whereas in case of positive sign, it is a case of absorption. See, the other parameter like this lambda, frequency, mu, all the parameter of the light are a positive quantity. So therefore, it is best to describe the part energy difference delta E is equal to upper minus E lower. So if you just replace this C term by this Rydberg constant and if you calculate the value, so it will come out to be this 2.47 into 10 to the 15 hertz, where Rydberg constant in terms of hertz unit, I have written over here 3.2 into 10 to the 15 hertz. So let us summarize the emission spectra of a hydrogen atom and what we have learned in this chapter. So you can see that the energy expression of a hydrogen atom you can derive by using Bohr's theory. I have not shown the derivation. The energy comes out to be minus 13.12 Z square by N square. In case of hydrogen atom, the Z is equal to 1. And you can put the any value of N, that is the principal quantum number, in order to get the energy of the particular orbit, energy level. And energy expression in terms of Rydberg constant, it can be written as minus RH CH into Z square by N square, where Z is equal to 1 for hydrogen atom, that is the atomic number. C is the velocity of the light, H is the Planck's constant, and N is the principal quantum number. So if you can use this energy expression to calculate the energy of particular energy state, also the you can calculate the energy difference delta E when electron jumps from one energy level to another energy level, and thereby you can calculate this frequency wavelength associated with the electronic transition. So Lyman lines, it falls in the ultraviolet region, UV region. As you can see that when the lines falls from this high energy level to the n is equal to 1 state, it forms this Lyman series of line. This first line, it is called this Lyman series alpha line. Second line is called beta line. And subsequently, there is a series of line spectrum for the Lyman series. Similarly, when this line electronic transition corresponds to n is equal to 2 state from the higher energy level, it forms this Bummer line. And this Bummer series line, you can see that it falls in the visible range. Similarly, there is infrared pass chain series which falls in the IR region. There are two more series, that is bracket series and fan series. For bracket series, N1 is equal to 4, and for fan series, N1 is equal to 5. So you can understand that. So there are several of this such discrete energy level electronic transistor, which gives this visible gives this emission spectrum. So these visible lines I have already mentioned of the hydrogen spectrum, they are called Bummer line. Also you can understand that this lower wavelength 397 nanometer light to, if you increase the light wavelength 656 nanometer along this series, you can see that from this blue to red the wavelength increases, but energy and frequency gradually decreases, as I have mentioned in the one of the first slide, because of this fundamental formula C is equal to nu into lambda. From Bohr model to quantum mechanics, there are several advantages and drawbacks regarding this Bohr model. First point is that this theory was a great accomplishment and radically changed our view of matter. It nicely explains the emission spectrum of hydrogen atom, but there are drawbacks also. It cannot explain the spectrum of atoms of other than hydrogen atom, like multi-electronic system helium. This theory fails to prove that. Also, it unable to explain the splitting of spectral lines in the presence of magnetic field, that is called G-Man effect, or an electric field, that is Stark effect. So in presence of this electrical field and magnetic field, the emission spectrum line of this Lyman-Balmer of the line that I have talked about, they are further splitted and give this hyperfine splitted line emission spectrum of hydrogen atom. But from Bohr theory, there is no explanation of this hyperfine splitting line in presence of magnetic field and electrical field. Second point is that this Bohr theory introduced quantum idea artificially. Here electron is considered as particle, whereas in the latter stage, de Broglie, in his hypothesis, he proved that the electron also have wave-like property. So in the next lecture, we will talk about this wave mechanics of this atom. Now we should go to quantum mechanics to wave mechanics. Now, before going to the wave mechanics of atom, let us take this example and learn the concept of ionization energy. Now, what is the definition of ionization energy? Ionization energy is the amount of energy needed for an isolated gaseous atom in its ground state to discharge an electron resulting in a cation. So, this hydrogen atom, it exists in H neutral molecule, neutral atom, H gas. So in order to produce H plus and one electron, the amount of energy you required is called ionization energy. So ionization energy, the value you can calculate for hydrogen atom is equal to E infinity minus E1. That is, you can see that this is a nucleus. This is the one electron resides in this first orbit. Principal quantum number n is equal to 1. So if you remove this electron to the infinity energy level, to the energy level E is equal to infinity, the energy required delta E, which is equal to the ionization energy. So for this ionization energy process, the energy will be calculated by using this formula, as I have already mentioned that energy we can express in terms of Rydberg constant R Ch Z square by N square, where R is the Rydberg constant, C is the velocity of the light, H is the Planck's constant. For hydrogen atom, Z is equal to 1. So you can put this value, N is equal to 1 and N2 is equal to infinity, and you can get the value in terms of joule. This is joule per atom. For one atom, the energy required is this. For one mole of substance, you can multiply this value to this Avogadro number, that is 6.022 into 10 to the power 23. Then the unit will be joule per mole. And if you calculate this value, it will come out to be 1312 kilojoule per mole.
and by changing the unit conversion to the more convenient electron volt unit, you will get that 13.60 electron volt, and where 1 electron volt is equal to 96.5 kilojoule per mole. So therefore ionization energy IE of hydrogen atom is equal to 13.6 electron volt.